and it's on adding and subtracting fractions. Specifically, it's on adding and subtracting like fractions. And what I mean by like fractions is two fractions that have the same denominator. Right, so basically we're going to live by one rule, and that rule is that if we have two fractions like A over B and another fraction C over B, and they both have the same denominator, all we're going to do is we're going to add their numerators together and keep the same denominator. And like always, we are always going to reduce our answer. So let me show you an example of that. Oh, by the way, before I show you an example, if you have two fractions like A over B and you're subtracting C over B, nothing's really going to change. We're still going to only subtract our numerators and keep the same denominator. So A minus C and keep the same denominator, which is B. So let's see this. So let's say we have a quarter plus 2/4. We want to add those together. So let's see this visually before we add it together. So you can think of a quarter as a strip that's divided into four pieces, out of which we're choosing only one piece, right? And then 2/4 is another strip divided into four pieces, out of which we're choosing two pieces. So how many pieces am I choosing altogether when I add them both? Total of three pieces. One, two, three. So that we did that visually, we can also do it algebraically. Remember I said when I have two fractions of the same denominator, I'm just going to add up together the numerators and keep the same denominator. And what do I get out of that? 3/4. And I see if I can reduce it, and it just happens to be reduced in there. So I don't need to reduce it anymore. So let's try a couple of other examples. So let's say we have 6 over 13 plus 2 over 13. Well, I'm just going to follow the rules that I just came up with, which are we're going to add together the numerators. So that's 6 plus 2. And we're going to keep the same denominator, which happens to be 13. All right, 6 plus 2 is 8 over 13. Okay, try these. Try 5/8 plus 1/8. And then after that, try 20 over 11 plus 6 over 11 plus 7 over 11. What did you guys get for the first one?
3/4.
Okay, before you reduce, you get 6 over 8. And then if you reduce that, 6, sorry, that should be an equal sign. 6 breaks up into 2 and 3. And 8 breaks up into 2 and 2 and 2. And then you can get rid of the 2s, and you're left with 3/4. Okay, what about the second one? Alright, so let's add. So we add the 20 plus the 6, that's 26, plus 7, what's that?
33
over 11, and then I can reduce that, right? What is it reducing to? Just 3, right? Or 3 over 1. Good. Okay, we can also, remember I said we can also do it with subtraction, and it's not going to be much different. So say that we have 11 over 12 minus 6 over 12. Well, I'm just going to take 11 minus 6, put it all over the same denominator, which is 12. And what's 11 minus 6? 5 over 12. I can't reduce this, so it stays there. What if we had 7 over 15 minus 2 over 15? What would you get out of that? Hmm? 5 over 15, I need to reduce, and what does it reduce into?
1/3.
Good. Okay, and finally, let's look at a case where we have a couple of integers mixed in. So say we have negative 8 over 17 plus 4 over 17. So let me remind you of something, of when we have negative a over b, we're going to say that's equivalent to a over negative b, and we're going to say that's also equivalent to the opposite of a over b. So what we're really saying in the first case is, in the first case we're saying a negative number divided by a positive number. And a negative number divided by a positive number is a negative. In this case we're saying a positive number divided by a negative number. A positive divided by a negative is also negative. And in this case we're saying two positive numbers and then the opposite of that, which happens to be negative. So in all these three cases we're going to evaluate to get a negative answer. So all those three mean the same thing. What doesn't mean the same thing is if I had negative a over negative b, because what would that evaluate out to be?
A positive.
Yeah, negative divided by negative would cancel out to be a positive. And this is, of course, assuming that all a's and b's are positives, but they could be negatives as well. All right, so keeping that in mind, when we want to do this problem right here with negative 8 over 17 plus 4 over 17, I'm just going to assign the negative to the 8. So it becomes negative 8 plus 4 over 17. What do you think that gives you?
Negative 4/17.
Yes, good work. That's my final answer. Questions so far? Okay. Try these. Evaluate x plus y if x equals negative 10 over 12 and y equals, let's just say, and 5 over 12. And also try this one. Find the perimeter of a square that measures 3 over 20 of a mile on each side. Try those two.